Hello guys, welcome to Evolving Knowledge Channel. Ready to learn? In today's video, I'm going to talk about the atomic bomb. I'll explain nuclear fission and how scientists used this knowledge to develop the most destructive weapon already invented by humans. Join us, and let's get started. At the beginning of the 20th century, several scientists were studying the atom and subparticles such as electrons, neutrons, protons, etc. Important scientists that we can highlight are Ernest Rutherford, Niels Bohr, Robert Millikan, James Chadwick, Albert Einstein, and so many others. But before talking about the atomic bomb, first of all, we have to understand an important concept in chemistry, which is nuclear fission. Do you know what is that? Nuclear fission is the process of splitting apart nuclei. When large ones, such as uranium-235, fissions, energy is released. Nuclear fission is part of a topic in chemistry named nuclear reactions. We can define nuclear reactions as a change in the identity or characteristics of an atomic nucleus induced by bombarding it with an energetic particle that could be an alpha particle, a gamma ray photon, a neutron, a proton, or a heavy ion. Now, let's go back to uranium-235. This is an example of nuclear fission. A neutron bombards uranium-235, and it is produced barium, krypton, and 3 neutrons. In this process, a large amount of energy is released. Otto Hahn and Fritz Strassmann discovered this reaction in 1938. Let's talk about mass conservation. Look to the equation again. The atomic mass of uranium is 235 plus 1 of the neutron, total 236. On the right side, 144, plus 89, plus 3 times 1, equals 236. Mathematically, it makes sense, but in the chemical experiments, the mass of barium and krypton is lower. Why? Remember this famous equation here? Energy equals mass, times square c, where c is the light speed. Okay, so Einstein demonstrated that mass could convert into energy. So, part of the mass on the product side is converted to energy. This phenomenon is called a mass defect, when the conservation of the mass does not work. This is the reason we called these reactions as nuclear and not chemical ones. In the chemical reactions, the mass of reactants and products is the same. The enormous energy that's released from the nucleus splitting comes from how hard the protons are repelling each other with the Coulomb force, barely held together by the strong force. This huge force over a small distance leads to a fair amount of released energy, which is large enough to cause a measurable reduction in mass. Looking at the uranium reaction again, the smaller nucleic is generated, 3 other neutrons are released, and they will bombard other uranium atoms, and more energy is released. We call this process as a chain reaction. This energy can be used to generate electricity in nuclear plants. I have a video on this channel where I explained that. See this card above. With the amount of energy released in nuclear fission, the scientists figured out that it could be utilized to create weapons. With this understanding, physicist Leo Szilard contacted Albert Einstein to help him to warn the US government during the World War II. He wrote the famous letter to President Roosevelt saying that Nazi Germany was close to control the technology to create a nuclear bomb. This event can be considered the origin of the Manhattan Project. In 1942 in New Mexico, USA, it was created the American Atomic Central, Los Alamos lab led by Robert Oppenheimer. The physicist Enrico Fermi was also an important mind in this project. Is this lab? They obtained the uranium-235 and created the bomb, by development all technology required. In 1945 the first atomic bomb was created, made by plutonium. The bomb was named Trinity and it was tested in New Mexico. But how fission bombs work? These bombs are separate blocks of uranium or plutonium that can reach the critical mass, the minimum amount of nuclear material needed to maintain the fission, and together with explosives, it can release a massive amount of energy. Unfortunately, 2 bombs were used in Japan, the first on August 6 in Hiroshima. The second one exploded in Nagasaki 3 days later. This is a sad chapter of human history when thousands of people died. These bombs ended the World War II. Because of these bombs, the world changed forever, and while we still have these bombs activated, our planet will be less safe. Even if modern nuclear weapons can be a little bit different, the idea is similar. The countries that are known to have nuclear weapons are the United States, Russia, the United Kingdom, France, China, Pakistan, and India. Israel has not officially acknowledged its nuclear capabilities. Estimates of its arsenal have typically been around 8 warheads, although some estimates are significantly larger. North Korea's capabilities are largely unknown. It's suspected it may have a limited arsenal of 5-10 weapons, but may have material to build twice that many. Hey guys, we are at the end of another video. Did you like it? Please give us some feedback in the comments below. Before you go, don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye.